public pool, a leather couch, I lay beside you thinking it's all real. Elbow touch, no kiss here. He wants to have you, but he won't, he leaves. Sweet words to another one. And your face looks like you knew alone. Cuddled from my backside. And now this horse will take you for a ride. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Dragon's tail and fire death on the mountains of St. Mary's Church. Us two in a different place. I'm waiting for us to lives to end. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Starting point, starting point. Yes, she calls us the starting point. Yeah. point. Yes, she calls us daddy. Starting point, yes, she calls us the starting point. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the German Grand Prix. We are here at the amazing Hockenheim Ring, moments away from the start of the qualifying session. This is a place well known for shocking races thanks to the moody weather that likes to make conditions wet from time to time. And this year it should be no different. We are expecting rain in both the qualifying and the race. How much rain? I have no idea. This can create many overtaking maneuvers and send everybody, including the championship leaders, straight into the walls. Last year it was a McLaren 1-2 with Carlos Sainz winning the race. Can the championship leader repeat the success from the last year? Peter Roche, who finished second, is in deep need of points, and this weather is not great news for him, as he much prefers to drive in the dry conditions. Lukas Weber had his first career win here with Williams. Can he, today, repeat that day and get back to the top of the standings? We cannot forget about the second Ford car. Max Verstappen loves races like this. He always finds himself in chaos, and he showed that in the last race at Silverstone, taking all 26 points with a win and the fastest lap of the race. Will it be one of those drivers, or someone will surprise us? After all, this is Hockenheim, and anything can happen here. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is Peter Roche here, and this is the German Grand Prix, as I said. Let's start the qualifying session. We'll have to go out quite quickly because it's already raining. However, it is damp. My favorite condition, Bart. Yes, I had the looper under my feet, Bart. And hi, everybody. Hi, Apple Support Team. Hi, Brianna. Good to see you for the first time, by the way, I believe so. I'm just setting everything up and we'll be ready to go. Come on. Hi everybody, good to see you. It is raining, however it is, apparently everybody is out on the dry tires, so great, my favorite conditions. So far it is Q1, apparently it's supposed to be dry in Q3, I believe so. That is my prediction. Hey, hi, and hi Kevin, of course. Good to see you, of course. So, I've got everything ready except the fuel. I forgot about that, but let's just do that quickly.
Light rain will stay with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay.
Yeah. Come on, let's go.
Complete. All personnel be aware, we have a car leaving.
I think I can do that. I just need to gather myself up. The gap is quite big, P5. But I can definitely do that. Also, oh god.
Rewind. Engine off.
No, this is not the... Oh my goodness, that did not happen. As you can see, conditions are absolutely brilliant.
And please tell me how is the audio. Is it not too loud from the game? It is really slippery. I wouldn't say it is for the... for the dry tires, but the DRS is available. One. Where is the knob? There it is. Should be alright, I think. Okay, Bart. Oh, you see, not much grip at all. But it is not for the intermediate tires for sure. I would say so at least. I don't want to use this fuel. And this ERS. Why am I using that? Okay, come on. The difficulty is at 100 because of the conditions. To be honest, go Max. Because you will be probably faster in Q1. That's my prediction. Come on, let's not spin, shall we? Beautiful grip. In the rain, I have no idea what's the weather gonna be. The icons were really confusing. I guess we'll just see. Also, I will not ruin the surprises for you. But to be honest, I have no idea what's gonna happen in the race. One. I think it was alright. Great. I will take that. That was tough. To be honest, Diana, I am having doubts if there is gonna be a season at all, the next one. I'm kind of thinking about taking this season a bit more slowly. And we'll just start another one in F1 2020 with my own team, I guess, in the new mode, because I would love to do that. We'll see. It's a little bit 50-50 for me, because I'm not sure how much I'm gonna feel like driving the game. I feel like I am a little bit... I don't want to play as much. I used to do races every day and, you know, parts of it is also streaming. I'm kind of thinking maybe it's gonna be better to just do it more slowly and this season. We'll see. The lap was, thank God, good. Oh my goodness, we are so much faster on the... Nico, P3! Maybe he's gonna do that in the race, shall we? Oh, not anymore. Lukas Weber decided that it's not gonna be the day today. Carlos P5. If you are here for the first time, by the way, favorites for the win, as per usual, to be honest, Haas Ford, or rather Ford Haas, Williams with Lukas Weber and Valtteri Bottas, and McLaren with Carlos Sainz, and somewhere there should be a Russian driver. Oh, I missed him, probably. Where is he? The Torpedo, show yourself. Oh, here it is. Here he is.
You're doing a great job. We're much higher up the field than
yes, Bartz, I'm thinking about, and it's really up to you and the rest of the team, about doing sort of the streams with our sessions in Wreckfest. Because I have a wonderful time in that. And I think the rest would probably also enjoy this. Would you like to see some breakfast, everybody? With the connection lost racing team. Do I go out or not? Because now it's the question about the conditions. Oh, he just done it, by the way. Will this get more dry, the track? I think we're gonna do some breakfast. I will talk with the whole team about that, if they are fine with that.
It's pretty quiet out on track. We should consider getting out there.
It's pretty dry? You sure, Jeffrey? Breakfast in the breakfast, Kevin. Although we'll see, maybe there's gonna be some breakfast today.
We're 12th in
and unfortunately, there is no rewinds in breakfast. At least not in multiplayer. I don't think the conditions will be better. What do you think, guys? Do I go out once more? Because we are P2. Our time is absolutely splendid. I'm very happy with it. Lewis is last. Oh my goodness. And Tevon P18. So Porsche is doing absolutely tragically in their home race. Oh my. And by the way, also with the mods, because some of you might be interested in that. The next year mods that were planned. So that was TotoGP and that was also Martini Porsche. I think I'm gonna stick with these two and finish them because there is a lot of done with them. I am thinking about including them. If I'm gonna decide to not do the next season, I'm gonna include them sort of after Hungary maybe, because
this rain clearing up is about 10 minutes, so just keep your concentration.
10 minutes, right. So maybe I'm gonna include that after Hungary, so I think there is that break after Hungary, so we can make a story that Porsche earned a Martini sponsorship for the rest of the season, and TotoGP changed their livery to the more Monster Energy one because they paid them. So maybe that's gonna work. I would love to use them because they are freaking great. I am so happy with them. Yeah, there is quite a lot of Germans. How many? Three? 1, 2, 3. Ah, so Weber, Vettel, Hülkenberg. Now we only have Vettel, sadly. There is Zutil used to be in F1, I remember.
We're 12th in the speed trap, 337.
Well, we got to thank Mr. Schumacher for that. So about 15 minutes. I would go out, to be honest, at the end. Because if they are gonna jump me, then no thank you. That is not what I want. I think I'm gonna stay on this tire set, to be honest. I don't want to use another one.
Fastest lap is a 1:14.9.
Let's wait, shall we? Till maybe 2 minutes... 2:30? Just to be sure. Also, I started to play the new MotoGP game. I really freaking love it, I must say. If you are wondering to buy that, I would say go and do that. Although, the last game that I bought that was a motorbike game was MotoGP 3, which was released in 2005. So the jump step from that is absolutely massive, 2 generations. So for me it feels great. I'm not sure how the last MotoGP 19 game was. Oh, we should go out. Come on.
When you're ready,
should be good.
Let's go.
Yeah, I kind of hope that they will return. Some people are not fan of the fictional characters, but for me it feels alright. Although it might not be the case because F2 drivers will be in F1 2020, and that is phenomenal. So, as far as I know, or as far as I understood in the interview that was at the Red Bull page, it doesn't feel dry at all. I'm not sure how they're gonna improve. We're gonna have F2 drivers in F1 in our career mode. which is absolutely amazing. Go, leave me alone. I said go. Who is that? An Audi. I think that was Stroll. How do you like it right now? Because, like I said, I am having a great time, although I do struggle a lot on the MotoGP bikes, so the top of the top. Right now I am on the MotoGP 3, simply because I suck. I suck completely, because I do not play bike games at all. But let's do a lap, shall we? And we'll come back to that. Just to be sure. Oh my, that was scary. Jesus Christ. I know, Bart, but it's for fun. Come on, I can do everything here, so I'm gonna do everything that I want. This is fantasy. Fort will also be... won't be in F1, so you know. I like to do things that will not happen, obviously. So we can make them happen here. And rip DTM, by the way, because that's pretty much a certain thing. Unless they will change something, maybe. It would be cool to have them, of course. Ooh, Hortense. No chance. Ooh, Weber dropped us. Let's just came into the pits. Come on. Brian, I'm not gonna do that. No. I'm thinking about... maybe Jack Aitken? Why not? Or just pick someone that I don't know and to, you know, build them up to a superstar. We'll see. So this is the end. Who is out? Let's see the last five. Raikkonen, Magnussen from TotoGP, Kubica from TotoGP, Russell and Ricciardo from Red Bull Racing. Perez just squeezed through. Well, if you want to do that, why not, of course. That's the awesome thing, that's, you know, we have a choice. And it is not given to us and we have to deal with that. So it's dry, really dry. I'm gonna bump up the difficulty in Q3, because I think I will be much faster in dry. I just think the AI is too fast in conditions like that, especially because this was the first time it was kind of wet. And you know, as much as F1 drivers are great, they do not adjust just like that, because wet conditions are really not sustainable, consistent, you know. There is lots of different grip in lots of different places, and I believe they need to do some mistakes. Hopefully that will be in the next game. I believe in Cody's. The game is still great, I will always say that, but you know, you can always try to improve these things, and why not? Setup is good, I think. I did not change anything. 73 brake pressure, that felt great. I changed the power unit, some new components, because the reliability of them isn't exactly great. I needed to improve the speed of the car.
Okay,
because if we want to have a go at the championship, We need to be fast and be fast in every single race that is left. That should be good. Let's do a lap, shall we? Well, in this game, you don't choose that, which is... It is bad when you have a weird transfer, but to be honest, for this season, I had so many great transfers that made sense. So, it is hit or miss, but in this game, you cannot choose where everybody goes to. I'm not sure if that's gonna be the case with F1 2020. Good God. There is gonna be some kind of driver transfer system, so it won't be just, I guess, random. I don't know if it's random in this game, or there is some logic behind that. I think there is some, because some transfers just make more sense. So that is gonna be much more expanded in 2020. I still feel like there isn't a lot of grip. But maybe that's me. One. Oh God, that was white. Oh my! Well, I could have done one more, but oh well. I definitely can go faster than that. What would you like, Kevin? No, I don't, Brian. No, I don't like to be honest, sign up for betas of the game. I just like to have a finished product. Same thing goes to early access games. That's just how I prefer things from my experience. I'm gonna go out on the same tire set, probably. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah, that is a great idea, to be honest. Because that would never happen. I guess there should be something done about Stroll, because, well, mine Stroll is still in Racing Point, that became Audi.
We're top of the speed trap, 338.
But in many career modes, I saw that it was not the case. Everything is good. Do I take the new tire set? I would say no, I just need to gather up my skill. Hopefully it's gonna be bone dry. We need to gain at least 3 tenths. I'm not gonna take the tires, because I want to have 2 fresh sets. Yeah, Williams is in mine also. Williams really developed quickly, because in season 2 they won this race. That was what I was talking about. Lukas Weber won the race in the second season in 2020, which was crazy. And I was second, by the way. That was, I believe, my second podium. We need to put a faster time up on the board. I know, Jeffrey, I know. I will do that. I'm gonna take the fresh tire set, because if I'm gonna miss out on Q3, that is a big no-no. Can we go? I guess we can do 2 lap times. And what are you driving, Brianna? What is your choice of a vehicle? I don't know if Williams being on the top is realistic. For me, it's cool because it's nice to see. It's nice to have something different than if in F1 for me. That's what I like to use the game for.
All set. Everyone clear?
Except season 1. I like to have sort of realistic stuff in season 1 and then to change everything. Because if it's the same thing in older games, I felt like I didn't really want to do another season. When it was time for Melbourne, I felt like, oh god, it's another season. And with the mods, the transfers especially, Melbourne was always exciting. And also because of the fact that in my case, there was always a lot of work to set up the season with the helmets, with the liveries. So, you know, it was really satisfying to actually go out on the track with everything. Oh, okay. Ferrari here is a midfield team, more like. Charles is trying to do everything he can. And Red Bull, Red Bull is doing tragically. Sadly. Let's do this. Pretense, nice. I still can do better. Fortens. Man. Six tens? Yeah, P6. I'm kind of not sure about bumping up the difficulty, to be honest, in that case. Because they are freaking fast, and I'm not. So, okay, I'm gonna bump this up. I'm just gonna do a better job. Jesus Christ, so many time lost to Max. I did the qualifying practice program, and it was much better. Maybe the AI changed or something. Yeah, Daniel P4. He's doing quite well. I mean, he's P4 in the driver standings, right in front of me. We need to overtake him today, for sure. Butler. Oh, so Porsche is doing fine in Q3. And Hulkenberg. And who is out, by the way? Bottas in Williams is out. That is tragic, to be honest. Gasly, Perez. That is not a surprise. And Norris and Stroll in Audi. They have quite a fast car. They had the podium in Baku in that freaking crazy race where we crashed. I would love to have a pole. First, I need to have a drink for that. And we have one tire set. I'm gonna use this one at first, and in the last lap and the end of the session we'll use the new one. But right now I need some water.
Track is pretty empty right now. Lots of space.
Here it is. Cheers, guys. But first... I'm not gonna have enough for the race, but oh well. The race will be really freaking tough. Cause this track is quite intense, I must say. I did 5 laps in the program, in the race program. And I was so tired at the end. And I'm not sure how that is gonna look like in the race. Especially with the weather being... We're not sure what it's gonna be. Come on. Should be alright. I'm gonna wait a little bit so they will not block me. Let's go. There is a Porsche behind. P5. Not bad, to be honest. On the old tires. Yeah, thank you, Brenna. I hope I will too. I am really afraid about that weather, because that is just... The AI seem to be much better in conditions like that. Although sometimes they will do a weird strategy. I'm kind of hoping for that. We'll see. I just gotta try it. I feel like I have the pace to do that.
Our best lap so far is a 1.9.2.
1.9? That is quite fast to lap that track, I must say. Okay. We are going out at 2 minutes 20. Should be good. I would love to go out last.
We're top of the speed trap, 338.4 kilometers per hour.
Tires are good. Let's go.
Checks complete. We're ready.
And Max went. We've got 20 seconds of a delta. I think we need 6 tenths probably. That's a lot, but it is doable for sure. I felt like there was quite a lot of time to be gained. I just needed to get used to the conditions and the grip that we had. because there was absolutely none of it in Q1 with these damp conditions. Come on. Oh, fuck. That was allowed, somewhat. Come on. Come on!
Excellent lap. We're really pleased.
Well, you can't see that, but I can. It is not
P1. Race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting
it
the
It is P4.
Fiat and Carlos.
2/10.
With qualifying complete,
I really freaking tried. That was a good one, I think.
Uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us.
So Max Verstappen, the other Ford, is on pole. Kwiat P2, Sainz P3, I'm P4, Weber P5, Williams not that great here, Hamilton and Butler, so the Porsche duo, P6 and P7. P8 belongs to Charles Leclerc and Vettel and Hülkenberg, the German duo, P9 and P10. It is a okay place. I wanted pole, but I did not get pole. And let's bump up the difficulty to 103. And time to figure out some kind of strategy. Although we'll probably have to do that on the fly. Let me just adjust the fan. Oh, I'm losing the rivalry. Because I need some air. Race mode, please. Thank you. Okay.
All right. I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with
I wanted more, but oh well. And oh, by the way, here is the weather. You can see it now. I cannot make anything out of that because these clouds, the sort of clouds without sun at all. That is a possible rain, and that was the case in Paul Ricard. At least that was what Jeff was telling me. Hello, Bart. Good. It's good that you are here. We'll see. The engine is good. Let's go to the race and figure out the strategy.
There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix.
And thank you for the sub, Brian. I just noticed that on my phone.
And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me.
And thank you. By the way, I forgot to thank you guys. Thank you for 100 subs.
The 2.8-mile Hockenheim ring requires
precision
through the technical state.
This great, am I 2 months recording and streaming? Somewhere around that. It's been great so far. So thank you. Hopefully, we'll have more and more people on the streams, so we can all enjoy them.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race.
Are there some penalties?
Put in a fantastic lap yesterday.
Probably not, Carlos.
And just starting behind them is Daniel Kvyat, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of
no,
the
Carlos
today,
is P3.
We have Sainz, Rose,
no penalty.
Lucas Faber and Hamilton, Butler, Leclerc, Vettel and Nico Hülkenberg, Bottas, Gasly, Sergio Perez and Norris, Stroll, Ricciardo, George Russell and Robert Kubica, Magnussen and Kimi Raikkonen finishes off.
No penalties at all from anyone.
Away, it's time to go down to the track.
Jeff?
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up.
Honestly,
take
I expect
care.
Chaos. If they are gonna kill me, I will not forgive them. I think I'm gonna stick with the first. Or can I personalize that? I can. Oh, my tire wear isn't great at all. Usually it's better than the personalized. No, not projected. But it's really bad here. Can we change something for better? No, we can't. I think I'm gonna have to stick with that. The mediums should be fine. The softs should be really freaking hot. That's why we should probably pit at lap 10. 67 laps. My goodness, that's gonna be something today. But I'm not gonna give up. I'm gonna try to win this race. But that cloud is scaring me. So I'm gonna do that. Fuel seem to be alright, to be honest. I don't need more. Ah, should be fine. Everything here is good. It is. Okay, guys. Oh, let's start this. I think okay that we are on the inside and not on the outside, although we'll see. Weber might think otherwise. I wouldn't be surprised at all. Oh, bye Brian, I did not notice that. If you are watching that, of course, maybe later, thank you for being with me in the qualifying session. I should warm up the tires probably a little bit more. Oh, great. So probably soft. Not sure about the conditions. Oh, I need to change the ERS at the start. Great. Fingers crossed, everybody. I'm gonna need that. Because of that person. And to be honest, everybody behind him. I need to watch out, because they might be a little bit slow in T1. And I'm talking about D2 McLaren's and Max. Come on. Everybody's ready. Damn it. I upshifted twice, sadly. Could have been worse. We are P5. We need to stick with them. Hopefully I will have a chance to find a move, find the gap, really. It's tough to overtake without DRS.
Is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone.
Can I have a go? No, he's too far. This is gonna be tough, really tough. Fight up ahead. That is Max. That is great. Come on. So So we are back, P4. Try to catch Max. Not sure who is P1 and who is P2. I think Sainz is P1. That is my prediction. Max is going for it. That is not a very helpful information. I'm gonna assume it's gonna be damp. I have to. No other choice. Not a lot of grip in sector 3.
DRS
maybe?
Yes.
Good, I need some help. Wow, what a fight. No. If they're gonna undercut me, I am doomed. So P10, lap 10, you gonna pit? Not grip, no grip, I mean. Oh god, it's so tough. The tires are so hot, that's the reason. Another reason why we need to pit at lap 10. So far, let's try to stick with them. Oh god, that is so freaking tough. It's only lap 7.
Kvyat's out in front.
Kvyat is leading, oh my. And Weber is pushing behind us. And I think that's Hamilton behind him in his Porsche. Not a lot of grip here. It's really bad, as you can see. Be careful. We need to take what we have at the moment.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
And cut as much as we can, really. Out. Weber is getting closer, but not that much.
plenty of energy, switch to overtake and have a go. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap.
Oh, first cut. I don't care. Great, and we have DRS. One more lap till we beat. Out for that curb and that wall on the left.
In this lap, push now.
So far so good, however Kwiat is doing absolutely amazing. He is P1, you can see him on the map, the orange dot at the front. We are pitting this lap. Because my tires aren't exactly great.
Box this lap, please.
And I don't want to get undercutted. Great.
Complete, go now.
Watch out, don't crash.
Only one stop to go, one stop left in this strategy.
There is some traffic, which isn't great. That is always the fear about the undercut. But I hope they will pit now. And no later. So far there is a gap in front, which is great, although Sainz is quite far. And that is less ideal. Out. Oh my.
Let's turn up the ERS deployment.
Oh no.
Burn some of this energy.
Well, maybe Jeff was right. So far so good. Let's get him. And this will be interesting. Move of the season.
Max is coming in for his stop.
Come on, pit guys. Where is Max? We are in front. Traffic isn't that bad. No other choice. My, what a picture. And what a madness. So we are clear now. No one in front of us, I don't think so. Only Hulkenberg, who is yet to pit. And Kwiat is leading the race. For sure. I think he pitted. He had to. He's doing a phenomenal job today. This is the surprise that I was talking about in the beginning. I can break later. I have to. Although 2 tenths up because of the tires. Come on, use the tires. They are so much better. Not here. No corner cut. Just on the limit. Yeah, Kwiat is in front and they are on the soft tires. I prefer these ones, to be honest. Because of the temperature. The softs were so hot. Grip gone by lap 5. Oh god, be careful, it's raining. How was that not a corner cut? Well, I don't mind. But I do mind that it's raining. We'll see about the conditions. I need to push as much as I can till it's dry. We need to create a gap to at least defend this second position. Not like that. I think it's gonna be damp, so we'll not change the tires.
Slicks, these conditions bit greasy, but we're still nowhere near the changeover point.
The good thing about that is they will have to pit once more, or rather twice, and we just have to pit once, because no way the softs will survive a lot of time. I don't think so. 12 lap at least, so they will have to change at lap 24. That's my prediction. Not sure if I'm losing time or not to Sainz. Now the freaking lockup. I think it's getting a little bit more wet. Oh, definitely. I can feel that right now. Not great news. Need to be careful. Let's not do the Vettel here. Yeah, I think it's gonna be damp for sure. Watch out. This is gonna be tough. So far it's all right. There is maybe, I don't know, 5-10% less grip. I am worried about that under braking because of the lockups. So far so good. Oh, that would not happen in the dry. Yeah, lots of understeer. And you see the delta. Yep, I agree. I would prefer to have softs in this situation, but oh well. They would probably be used right about now. Oh my god. It's getting worse. Yep. Definitely bad. Let's try to defend and keep the car in one piece. Oh, the brakes, my goodness. So bad.
A new strategy is available on the MFT.
Oh my.
Copy that.
Lap 19, what? We'll see what Kwiat will do. Although he can pit for the race. I think it's time. Because I cannot keep the car in one piece. Yep, I think so.
Understood, copy that.
Yeah, Jeff insists. You insist, Jeff? You insist! Oh god. Oh, yep, it's time. I cannot survive on that. Please let me go back to pit stop as quickly as I can.
Okay, remember to pit this lap.
Yeah, I for sure remember. Oh yes, it's time. Well, that said, our strategy advantage is gone. Let's do that.
Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Release, release.
Watch out. Yeah, now we did not crash. Thank God. Oh God, it's still freaking bad. Still need to adjust to the conditions. But yeah, I don't have to do that. Provisional P4, I think now. Max is staying out. He's brave. But he's Max. Let's try to do it like in Silverstone. The pace was good, but we spun at the last moment. So let's skip that part, shall we? Max is speeding.
Max is in the pits. Max in the pits.
It's all about P3 for now. It's gonna be really tough. I keep saying that because it's true. It feels... the braking, guessing the grip. How much do I have it?
The gap to the car ahead is 2.3 seconds.
And not spinning is the hardest part. Oh, please, I don't want to do that. And not to do that. Oh God. I will try to catch him in the dry. Well, it's gonna be dry. Hopefully as soon as possible. Because you see what I am doing. Jesus. Ach, the lovely rain. Fiat is absolutely dominating. Oh God. Too fast. I'm still guessing where to brake. I'm getting there.
Increase ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge.
Yeah, but where? I will just spin if I use that. Like this. Not today.
Gap to teammate behind is 4.7 seconds.
Uh-oh. Hamilton is behind us. And then it's Weber, I believe. And Verstappen.
It's 3 seconds up on you.
No. Oh. I'm trying, man. Weather report.
We're looking at another 5, maybe 10 minutes of this rain. Inters seem like the fastest tire for now.
I need to watch out for the lockups because the tires don't like that. They're too hot, too hot. Shame that it isn't just dump.
The gap behind us is 2.8 seconds.
Oh, watch out. So far, all right. We are not losing time to Hamilton. The gap is still around 2.9 seconds. I'm trying to be consistent somewhat and to somewhat keep up with Carlos.
Okay, I think the track will be drying out quite soon. Mind you don't burn out your tires.
Good God!
Gap to car in front is 3.7 seconds.
Eh, not bad. Hello, William. Good to see you, my friend. Oh God. Give me some talent so I can survive this race.
Let's use some of this energy. Increase the
Please.
Deployment.
Ah. Oh la la. Thank you. Oh. He's drying up, I think. Oh god. Yep, I think so. Because it feels much worse. Oh god.
A new strategy is available on the MFT. We're leading our teammate by 3.5
seconds. Time is now? Oh my. Soft? You nuts?
Okay, copy that.
I would say mediums.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
The time is probably now. Yep.
Got that confirmed.
Box this lap.
Pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap.
You shall not pass. Oh god, no grip. How do they do that? How? It's impossible to drive.
Max is coming in for a stop.
I'm not sure, Will, if I am faster than you. You are playing on a little bit harder difficulty than me.
Go, exit now.
Yeah, I'm doing, I just...
Exit,
thank god. I will be on the server, same as you.
Look after these tires now.
Oh, the fuel isn't great. We'll worry about that later. I will try to do a no-stop from this point. Or I will try to put soft tires. Oh, Hamilton is going for it. It's still damp a little bit. I guess they wanted more people to race in general. I don't mind really. I will not be streaming that race though, because I don't think I can with the team speak and everything. I'm just gonna do that on my own with you, hopefully. Not sure if you and Bart want to be on the team, not on the team speak.
Okay,
I mean, on the team speak we have to be, of course, because it's mandatory. But on the Discord, watch out. We need to try to pick up the pace. Although I need to be careful with the tires and the fuel. Okay, man. Oh god. Push. Only just. It's So we are before. Sainz is on mediums, I believe. Not sure about Kwiat. And Hamilton on soft tires. Bottas in P5. What a comeback. Again, I will try to go for a no-stop from this point. But we need to pick up the pace. They are quite faster on the soft tires behind me. .8 the gap. We have two Williamses behind and Max. The fuel is not looking good. But we'll deal with that later. God damn it.
You've lost some time to the car behind.
Yeah, I can see that. Oh god, that was scary. Really scary. Bottas is going for it. No, he almost went into me. Man. Gap is getting bigger. Let's just try to keep everybody behind then. Hopefully we'll get them at the end of the race. Oh god, who was that? You silly boy. Bottas. He's going for it. Just stop the car.
Our gap to the car in front is 5.4 seconds.
Oh god. Like, what can I do about the fuel? Right now, not much. I need to push. Nice. I need to be careful now because the next warning is the penalty for the track limits. We have the gap. Verstappen is P5 somehow. Also on soft tires. Nice. Jesus Christ, 5 tenths. And 5 seconds to Hamilton, not too bad. I hope the tires will survive till the end. Can be tough. Seconds. The up to max is quite good. 2.5. And nice 2 sectors. Car feels great, I must say. Don't know what happened to it.
You might want to consider switching to a lower fuel mix.
And also that. Great one.
Max is in the pits.
And fastest lap from us. And they are pitting. That is great news for us. I think their tires just died. That's why we were so fast. I hope this set will survive till the end. If not, we're gonna pit for the soft tires. But I don't plan that. I don't want to. Not great first sector. Battery behind us. Look up. Oh god, watch out for that curb. I think my tires start to go off now. Yeah, I feel a little bit less grip. How are they doing? 11%. Yeah. Temperatures are okay.
Managing your tires. Manage your tires. The gap to the car ahead is 4.8 seconds.
So I think we are gaining a little bit. Max with the fastest lap time now. Sorry, paddle shifter. Watch out. Thankfully no crash. Yet. Lock up. Uh, 107 degrees on the left front. We need to avoid that. Hamilton in the pits, for sure, right? Safety car?
Safety car deployed. The safety car has been deployed. Watch your delta. Make sure you keep it positive as we catch the pack. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
I think I'm gonna pit for mediums. Can I? I can. I'm not sure, Will, to be honest, because I will be pretty tired after that. I will think about that, if you can allow me that. Oh, here he is. Box this lap.
Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
Because that is really freaking tiring. I think it's the good time to pit. Because on the old tires,
go.
It can be tough.
Go now.
And there shouldn't be much traffic. Please let it be a good decision. Oh my god, not that great. Hopefully better, but oh my. Well, it is what it is. I thought they were little bit more fresh. But we are still in a good position. Butler for sure has to pit. Not sure about the rest. I think Sainz also has to pit. Kwiat I have no idea because I don't see him at all in this race because he's so far ahead. And I was never in the second position, so I cannot check what tires he's on. I can ask Jeff, I think. Can we ask Jeff? Full race update?
P6, we have P6. Butler ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 3.3 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Leclerc behind, less than a second separate you. They're on old softs. Okay, gap to leader, 20.3 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now.
Yeah, but what about arrival status?
Is in first position. P1, the gap is 3.0 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. The time last lap was a 1 minute 47.2.
I don't know. The good thing is we can save the fuel. And we for sure need that. Hopefully we will go for one more. That is the dream. And Max is in front of us, or rather Butler, but I'm gonna have to go through him as fast as I can. He is not... Porsche isn't as fast as the Ford. So we must go straight to Max. I can see also Hamilton is in front of Max. So it's Kwiat and Alfa. Red Bull, Alpha and Red Bull are backmarkers. Hopefully they will not make a big mess that will lose time for us. Carlos is, I believe, P2. So it's Kwiat, Carlos, Sainz, Lewis Hamilton, Max Verstappen, Devon Butler, Peter Roche, Leclerc, I see Lukas Weber there and Sebastian Vettel. We'll have, I assume, 20 laps remaining. Fuel is good, thankfully. I think it's gonna be this lap that the safety car will come in.
Safety
yes.
Car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tires are up to temperature, and remember there is no overtaking until the timing line.
Yeah,
stay
let's make sure of that.
Until the green flags.
Fuel is okay, but I still feel like this is not gonna be enough to run on standard for the whole race. For the rest of it. Thank you guys. There was an Alpha also. I wonder what he will do. Unless he pitted or something. Max also has to pit. I hope this will be good for us. No, please. Charles. Not that aggressive, please. No, that's not great. But again, they have to pit, I think so, and we don't. There is that Alpha. Something's going on. That was scary. Oh God. He is crazy. I have less power than them for some reason. Max is speeding.
Max is coming in for a stop. Okay, the stewards have now enabled DRS.
That's great.
DRS is now online.
And not in this section. Now we are too far and Lucas isn't. Speeding.
Okay, you are currently two places above our objective, two places ahead of our objective.
Before, for now. Louis still to beat. Yarios, please, thank you. Thank you. I think he's gonna have DRS. Yep, that's not good. Here comes Weber. Yeah, mistake from me. Damn it. Should have done that differently. Weber won't be pitting, I'm pretty sure.
We're leading our teammate by 12.9 seconds.
Great. We are back. And we have the DRS. Not the time yet, too far. Next lap. Go, go, go!
Kvyat's out in front.
What a crazy German! But it worked. He just sanded it. Can we try it? Right. We've got 12 laps to catch Carlos. 2.6 seconds. It's like the last year Grand Prix for me. But that time we were both McLaren drivers. This time I am in the fourth, and hopefully my fourth is faster. CB tires. It's getting closer. I am catching Carlos, I think by 3 tenths this lap. Point three still. Nine laps remaining.
Norris has just put up the fastest lap of the race so far. Seconds.
2.2. I hope the fuel will be good. Might have to save it. Oh, Weber! I tried to block him. But he just squeezed in. Damn it. ERS is running out.
Battery charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy.
Everything is running out. Jesus. If I can get out of the DRS zone, almost. Silly lockups, but still up on the best time. He's mine. 8 stands. He's far away. 6 laps remaining. Not sure about catching Sainz, probably too late, unless he has some problem. My tires are starting to go off, and my fuel isn't great. I need to save some, probably in the last sector. Here comes the sun. Yep, Weber is coming. That didn't work at all. Come on, we need to push. 5 laps. Someone else coming? I don't think so, no. Hella close.
Our gap to the current front is 3.5 seconds.
Maybe I will get a point? No. No. Ah, almost without the DRS. He is quite far down. Carlos is out of reach for sure. All about defending that podium. He's already there. And the fuel, Jesus.
We're starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tires.
Really?
We won't be making another pit stop. We have 2 laps of fuel remaining.
So not too much. Come on. Only I will have to defend for that last lap.
Great maneuver. You made it look easy.
And the fuel is just on the limit. I will save it in the last sector. Right now we need to push. As much as we can. Come on! Let's have that podium. He's far away.
This is your final lap of the race.
He must be too far. 7 tenths. Yes, I think so. Come on! I will take that P3. Oh god, what a race.
We're really happy with that performance.
I know I wanted to win, but with all that crazy thing happening, the freaking safety car, the freaking rain.
Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart?
That conditions were absolutely horrendous. And Daniel Kwiat is your winner for today. What a shocking winner. I was not expecting him to do that at all. I was expecting this man to win, or Sainz, or me, or Verstappen. But the Torpedo is victorious. And it's a 1-2 for McLaren. We are P3. Good chunk of points. Oh, that was... that was really tough. But it felt great, I must say. One of the best races so that I had.
To see how this result affects the driver's championship.
That is why I really love this game. That is the best thing about this. To securing the championship after an incredible day of it racing, was a chaos, was but day, it's got to be a controllable Bottas, amount. That fight with Weber. There were so many things happening.
McLaren continue to increase their gap.
If you didn't, I really recommend watching the maybe the whole race, because that was phenomenal. Action all around. I will need to see it tomorrow. That's why I do these streams, to showcase such great things. So it's Kwiat P1, Sainz P2, we are P3, Weber P4, Verstappen P5, Bottas came back from P11 to P6, Butler in his Porsche P7, Hamilton in his Porsche P8, so they are the fourth fastest team, so it seems. Norris P9, what a comeback from P14, Leclerc P10, 1 point for Ferrari, he's doing a great job. Vettel P11, Stroll P12 for Audi, Hülkenberg P13, Russell P14, Perez P15, Magnussen for TotoGP P16, TotoGP not doing particularly great, such a shame. Raikkonen Mua P17, Kubica P18, Ricciardo P19, Gasly last because he had a problem. Let's look at the standings, shall we? We are still P5 because Daniel won the race, congratulations to him, but we are sort of getting there, although we also finished behind Sainz. Sainz is really good, looking good for the title. If it's not gonna be me, then in my opinion it's gonna be Sainz, because he is freaking phenomenal this season, and McLaren is doing a great job. Weber, something is missing, to be honest. He's not as overpowered as per usual. Verstappen might surprise. Kwiat, maybe, who knows? He can have a late charge at the title. We will fight till the end, I can promise you that. Anything interesting? Maybe let's look at the constructor standings. McLaren still P1. As I say, they seem to be the best team again. Williams P2, Haas, Ford Haas is P3, but it's only 7 points to Williams, so not too far. Porsche, as I said, the fourth team, so it seems. Audi isn't looking that great, although I think there will be a big fight for that before between Porsche and Audi. Then we have Renault and Ferrari, I think they will also fight for the sixth position, and Alfa, Red Bull and Toto GP will all fight for P8. Alfa so far 8 points, great job from, I believe it is Perez or not. Raikkonen has 1 point and Perez has 7 points, so brilliant job from him in that Alfa. And Red Bull has 5 points from whom? Where is he? Russell has 4 points, great job from him, and Ricciardo only 1 point, so George is so far doing better than Daniel. And let's just watch the highlights, shall we? Maybe they will show us something interesting. I always like to watch them. If not for the action, for the beautiful shots. Sometimes they are not that beautiful because they show nothing, but a lot of times I love that slow-mo shots. I will tell you which ones. Oh, we had some side pod damage, but I don't think that gave us some disadvantage. Oh, here is a move on Max. Nothing shown. This is the time when we were in the traffic after the first pit stop. Behind the Audi of Lance Stroll. And then there is the Red Bull of... I'm not sure, I think it was Daniel Ricciardo. And then the move. Actually, it was 2-in-1, I believe. On both the Red Bull and the Audi. Beautiful one. And that move on Sainz and Stroll, that was absolutely magnificent. One of the best moves that I ever had. And ooh, that was quite intense. There were some moments where I went off, but I am very happy about myself in this race. No major mistakes, no spins, no anything. I pushed like hell. I tried to do everything. Oh, that is the dive bomb from Bottas. That was a bit silly, to be honest, from him. A bit like, then he tried to overtake us, I think, but he failed. But as I said, I am really happy about, there's the corner cut. About myself, I tried to make the best out of the rain. It was freaking tough, but not sure if I could have done anything better. And here is the finish, so the highlights did not show that much, sadly. I hope that will be improved in 2020. Max Verstappen with the fastest lap. Oh, he was so freaking fast. I think we had the third lap time. Yeah, so it seems. Although not. Yeah, Vettel had the fastest lap. I think some people had the soft tires at the end. So, guys, thank you. That was the German Grand Prix. It was freaking awesome. I had a wonderful time. Not sure when the next race is gonna be. Definitely next week. Maybe Monday. Although probably Tuesday, I will let you know probably in the morning of the day when the stream is gonna be. That's what I always do, somewhere around 12 p.m. Oh, Alessio, hi Alessio, by the way, you have to watch this race. It was absolutely stellar. Don't watch these results. Where is the come on? No. Don't watch. Don't go back. That was a freaking phenomenal race. I won't tell you what happened, but it was... I am so satisfied with myself. There was so many action. There were some interesting conditions. And it was phenomenal. I am so happy. We had many bad races this year, but this for sure wasn't one of them. Watch it, Alessio, really. I'm not sure if it's gonna be available when I'm gonna end the stream. I think the last 2 hours will be available, so probably the race will be available. If it's not gonna be, and it's gonna be somewhere around in the middle of the race, it's gonna be definitely available, I think, tomorrow, somewhere around morning and afternoon, maybe. But tomorrow for sure. Let's see, Alessio. So, bye from me, from the live one, and see you to the recorded one. So, thank you to everybody who watched, and see you in the next one. Bye bye, everybody. And Alessio, tomorrow it should be sort of converted or whatever it's doing to widescreen resolution, because I think you have the widescreen, so it's also gonna look much better. The resolution will be much bigger if that's what you would like. So it's your choice, really. It might be looking a little bit rougher today, but tomorrow it should be very sharp. So bye again.